Hello everyone, this is Anal Baduraya from Canara Engineering College, Information Science Department. So, in the last video, we had understood the concept of binary search trees. Okay, so once we have, along with the concept, we have also understood what is the exactly the difference between the binary tree and binary search tree. So, BST is nothing but a binary short form for the binary search tree. Okay, then after that we understood the creation function and creation function and the insert function, okay, for binary search tree. And at the end we discussed a small problem which has exactly told us how to put the elements into the binary search tree. So by using the algorithms or the steps or the C codes in the last video, we had by putting the same concepts, okay, into the problem, we had successfully created the binary search tree in our previous video. In today's video, we will see how to search the element. So we will take the same example of same tree example which we have taken in our last video. Okay, using that same example, we'll search an element in the binary search tree. Okay, so that is our topic for today's topic is searching in binary search tree. Okay. Yes. So if you see the example today, I will just put a rectangular mark, okay, around the tree. This tree was created in our previous video. If you see our previous video, we have exactly seen how this tree was created. Okay, so this tree is basically a binary search tree. Okay, why it is a binary search tree? Because here we can observe that elements smaller than info of x is to the left, and elements greater than info of x to the right. And one more condition was when the same element was there, if your info x and the data are same, at that time we need to see the left of info of x. And if the info of x is empty, if the left of the info of x is empty, and in such case we need to put that same element there. Okay, otherwise we had to put it to the right. Okay, so the same example, same thing we had seen, that is nothing but in the case of number 5 and 8 which are repeating here, we can see here. Okay, so we already had the element there, that's why we put the second 5 to the right of the first 5 and 8 5 to the second 8 to the right of the first 8. But here, when in the case of 2, there was no left child for the 2, so that is why we put the 2 to the left. Okay, so that example, or both examples, both conditions we had seen while doing the problem in our last example. Okay, now today taking the small example, our today's thing is nothing but how to search a particular element. Okay, yes. So here today I am taking the data 8. I need to search. So where our operation starts? It starts from root node. Because I need to go through all the elements. All the elements means according to our condition. Remember, all the element doesn't mean that you need to go through all the elements in the tree. Okay, according to our condition, you have to start from the beginning, that is the root. So here 6 is the root and 8 is the data which we have to search. Now we have to see whether 8 is present, whether 8 is present in a tree or not, okay. Yes, so what I am doing is nothing but, so you have a sequence of, you have a four steps process, so you need to understand these four steps. Okay, if there is no node, if not of node, what do you mean by if not of node? If not of node means if there is no node, then there is no data, then there is no data. Else if data is less than node of data. Okay, that is nothing but, yes, if here what is data? Here data is nothing but 8. And what is there in the node of data? Okay, that is 6 node of data you have 6. Okay, we are still at the root level only, so node of data will be 6. Node of data, remember, data will is the one which we have passed, which we are checking, so that won't change, but node of data will change with the iterations. Okay, so node of data is nothing but 6, and 8 is the data. So we can see in our first year, okay, 1 year, which I'm rectangular, which I'm putting a rectangular mark now. So 8 is, we can see, we have seen that what is 8? 8 is, it is checking whether 8 is less than 6. 8 is not less than 6, so that is why it is false. Okay, that is why it is given as F. F means false. Okay, so what we are supposed to do? If it is false, then you have to go to the left subtree. Okay, you have to go to the left subtree. You have to go to the left subtree. Okay, yes. So students, just a minute. Yes, else if data is less than node of data. Okay, sorry, our data is 8 here. Our data is 8 here, and node of data is 6 here. Remember, okay, node of data is 6, and our data is 8. So we have to go to the next condition, that is data is greater than node of data, then search in the right subtree. Okay, so as we have already seen, 8 is not less than 6, so that is why we put a cross mark here. But our next condition becomes true, that is 8 is greater than 6. Okay, where our 8 is the data and 6 is node of the data, so you have to search to the right. You have to search to the right. So once you come to the right, what is your new node of data? Your new node of data is 9. Okay, your new node data is 9. So that is what they are telling. 8 is less than 9. 8 is less than 9. Now our first condition here, that is our else if first else if condition is valid. That is data is less than node of data, where data is 8 and node of data is 9. Okay, so you have to again go to the search in the left. Okay, you have to again search to the left. So again you have to, so you know that these four steps are basically iteration thing. So again it will check. So 8, now again what it will do is nothing but whether 8, okay, now again when you go to the left of 9 you get 8. So now it is checking whether 8 is less than 8. It is false. Okay, then it will check whether 8 is greater than 8. It is also false. Then finally it will come to your else condition, whether that is else data is equal to node of data. So when you get the last condition, that is data is equal to node of data, that time you can tell that data is found. So here we see that 8 is equal to 8. Equal to means you are comparing. Double equal to means you are comparing. So when 8 is equal to 9, data is found. So in this case, the data is present in the tree. So that is what we understand through these steps. So this is an algorithm. Algorithm you can tell. It is an algorithm for searching in a binary search tree. So students, it is you know that we write the same C code based on the algorithm itself. Okay, so you will not find the much change here, but still for our information we'll read. Okay, so find element. Okay, find element is your function name. Okay, so void void is the data type. Okay, so void is your data type. For the find element is your function name. Okay, use a function name and struct node star node. So this is the nodes. Okay, different node. Okay, so value keeps on changing here, which starts from root. We know that in data is a data, fixed data which we are sending. So in the last example we have taken 8 here, and here root was 6. Okay, 6 which is root, starts from root. Okay, we can tell that starts from root. From root. Okay, yes. So the first condition, if not node, then what is this? PF means printf. You have to write it printf, students. Don't write PF. You will not get the output. So you are supposed to write printf. So this condition will never execute. So element not found, because you have the because you have to go through the entire tree. Okay, then it will check to a first else if condition. So data is less than node of data. Okay, so of course 8 is greater than node of data. Even this condition will not execute. Then it will go to the next condition, else if condition, that is if data is greater than node of data. Yes. Okay, so we had gone to the right. Correct. No, that time we had found out 9. Okay, and 9 is greater than 8. Correct. No, then we had again gone to the left. Okay, that is the first else if condition had executed. Okay, then once everything was done, when we went to the left once again, that time the data was matching, that is 8 is equal to 8. So that time our last else condition executed, that is printf data found. So in the earlier example, in the earlier slide, they had told you the algorithm for searching, and in this slide they are simply telling you the C code. Both are one and the same. Okay, we always students always remember that we develop the C code from the algorithm itself. We develop the C code from the algorithm itself. Okay, so this is all about the searching. Okay, so we also had to understand the traversal thing. So we had a long video previously where we also we have discussed the rules for the, that is the steps for the traversal. So which are the traversal techniques we had studied in the previous videos? So we had studied the traversal techniques of pre-order, in-order and post-order. So we had also solved a couple of problems, okay, where we were finding the where they had given the tree and we had finding we found out the pre-order, post-order and in-order traversals. We had so various methods of finding pre-order, in-order and post-order traversal was there. So we had traversed it, okay. So 2-3 examples we had taken, we were clear with that, okay. Then after that we had also taken the pre-order and post-order traversal along with the in-order traversal, okay. Then we had to construct a tree, we had done that also, and along with that we had discussed the steps, but nowhere we had discussed the C code, okay. So in this slides, okay, in this set of slides we will discuss the C code also. We will discuss C code also for pre-order traversal, in-order traversal and the post-order traversal. So what we were doing with the pre-order students, in the pre-order traversal first always what we were doing is nothing but we were visiting the route first, okay, then we were visiting the left first, then we were visiting the right first, correct, no? And whenever we were visiting the route, we used to print, okay. So when we visited, route, okay, that when we visited route, that time we printed, correct, no? That time we printed, so that is how it works also. So void pre-order is the name of the function. So struct node star node, because we are taking the node here. If node is not is equal to null, then what we are supposed to do, printf percentage d node of data, node of whichever is data is there, okay. So we used to print it first, then we call the left, this is this we call it again and again, same function, which is also the recursion concept. Once left is done, then we used to call the right. So that is the C code for the pre-order traversal. And what was happening in an in-order traversal? In an in-order traversal, it was the left tree first, followed by the root in the middle. Then we used to go to the right. So that is how it is. So wherever root that thing came, we had to print. So first we will call the in-order here to the left top tree. Then we visit the root. That is the when we visit the root, we print it. Okay, any element when we visit it. Okay, that time. Instead of telling to a root, no, that we can tell we were whenever we were visiting the element, we used to print it. So of course that is printf. I had already told you these are the function calls to the left and right subtrees. So mod d node of data. So whatever data is there, then whenever we visit that we print. Then we again go to the right. So this is the in-order traversal. Then the C code for the post-order traversal. So this is the C code for the post-order traversal. So what we used to do there, okay, if node is not is equal to null, okay, then we used to go to the left first, okay, then we used to go to the right, then this comes at the end, okay, right here, I'll write right here, don't get confused, this comes here, okay, this comes here, that is why I have done the arrow mark here. Printf node of data comes to the node, why? Because here it is like left, go to the left first, then go to the right first, next then go to the left right, then visit, or then root, okay, then root. So root is at the end, we visit the it at the end. So remember, okay, right here. So how does it come? So left, then right, then root, okay, then root. That is nothing but here you have to print, print here. Whenever root comes, print here. Okay, so that is about the post-order traversal. Thank you. So this is thank you everyone. This is all we have in this video. In the next video, let us discuss about the deletion in the binary search tree with couple of examples. Okay, couple of examples we'll take and we'll understand the deletion process also in our next video. Thank you.